Hi everyone, this is Toyba from Toys Lab Creations. Today I'm going to be making a tutorial on a cowl neck top. It's a summer top. For this project, I'm going to be needing fingering weight here, and it's going to be very light. 5mm hook, tapestry needle, and then stitch markers. So to start, I'm going to make a slip knot and then make a chain of 76. This top is for bust 34 to 36 inches. So go ahead and make a chain of 76. Make sure your chain is not too tight so you can work into them on the first row. I will join you when I'm through with my 76 chains. So I've made 76 chains. I'm going to skip the first three chains. Remember, the one on the hook does not count as a stitch. So I'm going to skip 1, 2, 3. Those three chains are going to count as a double crochet. Into yarn over and make a double crochet into the fourth chain from the hook. Then I'll chain one, then skip a chain, and then make a V-stitch into the chain after the one that I skipped. So to make a V-stitch, I'm going to go into that chain, yarn over pull through two, and yarn over pull through two. That's just a double crochet. Then chain one and then make one more double crochet into the same space. So that's a V-stitch. So I'm going to skip two now, skip two chains, one and two, and into the next one make a double crochet chain one and then another double crochet all in the same stitch. So that's another V-stitch. So I'm just going to keep repeating that. I'll skip two chains, one and two, and into the next one make a double crochet chain one and another double crochet all in the same stitch. And I'll join you when I'm about to finish the row to show you how to end this row. So just keep going ahead and skip two chains and make a V stitch into the next stitch, and I'll join you when I'm almost through with the row. So I'm about to finish the first row. I have four chains left. So I'm going to chain one now, skip two chains, and make a double crochet into each of the last two chains. So go into the second to the last one and make a double crochet, and then a double crochet into the last stitch. So this is what the first row looks like. Now these two double crochets at the end and the two double crochets at the beginning are also counting as V-stitches. So if I count all the V-stitches I have all together with the double crochets on the edges, I have to, a total of 25 V-stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. So we have 25 V-stitches. So moving on to row 2 now, I'm going to chain 3. Remember, the chain 3 counts as a double crochet. And 3, turn. And then yarn over and make a double crochet into the next double crochet from the previous row. So I'm going to chain 1. And then make a V-stitch into this chain 1 space from the V-stitch from the previous row, chain one, and then make a double crochet again. I'm just going to be beading on our V-stitches, yarn over and make another V-stitch into this chain one space here on top of the V-stitch from the previous row. So just keep doing that, making V-stitches on top of V-stitches, and I'll join you when I'm about to complete the row. So I'm about to complete row 2. I've made the last V-stitch here. So I'm going to chain 1 and make a double crochet on top of this double crochet, and then a double crochet on top of the chain 3 So with that, I'm through with row two. So we're just going to keep repeating row two. So just chain three, turn, that chain three count as a double crochet, then make a double crochet into the next stitch, chain one, and then make a V-stitch into the V-stitch from the previous row. So just keep repeating row two over and over again until I get to row 45. So just keep repeating row two until you get to row 45, and I will join you when I get to row 45. So I've made it to row 45. So this is my back panel. So to make my front panel, I'm just going to repeat on how I started my back panel. I'm going to chain 76 and then make the first row and the second row. So you can just watch that again, make your first row and second row, and keep repeating row 2 until you get to row 32. So I'll just go ahead and do that, and I'll join you on row 32 of my front panel. So I've made it to row 32 of my front panel. Remember, we have 25 V-stitches, including the double crochets on the edges. So I want to mark the middle V-stitch. That will be the 13th V-stitch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So I'm going to mark the 13th double crochet. I'm sorry, 13th V-stitch. So for our row 33 now, I'm going to start as normal, chain 3, 1, 2, 3, turn, make a double crochet into the next stitch, chain 1, and then make a V-stitch on top of the V-stitch from the previous row. So just continue as normal until I get to the marked V-stitch. So just keep making V-stitches on the V-stitches from the previous row, and I'll join you when I get the marked V-stitch to start the curl effect of our top. So I've made it to the marked V-stitch. So I have a total of 12 V-stitches plus the double crochet on the edges. I have a total of 12 V-stitches. So this is a 13th V-stitch. I'm going to remove my stitch marker. I'm going to make an increase into this V-stitch. So I'm going to go in and make a V-stitch, chain one, and then a double crochet again. I'm going to mark the V-stitch I just finished making. Then into that same space, I'm going to make another V-stitch. So I'm making an increase into the 13th V-stitch. So I'll be having two V-stitches into the V-stitch from the previous row. So I have two V-stitches now. I'm going to be marking both of them. So I'm marking the second one too. So I'll just finish the row as usual. Continue, make a V-stitch into the next V-stitch. Remember, we had 25 V-stitches previously. So because of the increase, now I'm going to be having a total of 26 V-stitches at the end of row 33. So just go ahead and finish your row as usual, and I will join you on row 34. So I'm through with row 33. Moving on to row 34 now, I'm just going to chain 3, turn, and continue as usual. Make a double crochet into the next stitch, chain 1, and then make a V-stitch on top of the V-stitch from the previous row. So I'm just going to make a V-stitch into each V-stitch. And when I get here, I'm going to make a V-stitch into each of the V-stitches that I mark. I'm just going to move the stitch marker up. So at the end of 34, I have a total of 26 V-stitches. So I'm not making any increases. I'm just going to go into each V-stitch and then make each V-stitch into each of them. So just go ahead and make a V-stitch into each V-stitch. Don't skip anyone. We have 26 V-stitches at the end of this row. I will join you at the end of row 34. So I'm through with row 34. I have 26 V stitches. So moving on to row 35, I'm going to make another increase on this row, but we are going to start as normal, chain 3, turn. Remember, chain 3 counts as a stitch. Make a double crochet into the next stitch, chain 1, then make a V stitch on top of the V stitch from the previous row, and keep making V stitches to get to the marked V stitches. So I'll join you when I get to those marked V stitches. So I've made it to those marked V stitches. So I'm going to remove the first stitch marker here and then make a V stitch into that space. Then I'll make another V stitch into the same space. So I'm having two V stitches here. I'm making an increase, chain 1, and then finish the second V stitch. So I'm going to be marking this second V stitch, and then remove this stitch marker too, and then go in and make a V stitch. I'm going to mark this V stitch, and then I'll make a second V stitch into the same space. So it means I've increased my V stitches by 2. So I'm going to have a total of 28 V stitches at the end of this row. So I made 2 here, I marked the second one. I made 2 here, I marked the first one. So these are the 2 center one now. So I'm just going to complete the row as usual. Make a V stitch into each V stitch across. At the end of row 35, should have a total of 28 V stitches. We increase 2 V stitches on this row. So just go ahead and finish row 35, and I'll join you on row 36. So you can see our top is beginning to get wider in the middle. So I'm through with row 35 now. So for row 36, start as usual, chain 3, turn. The chain 3 counts as a double crochet. Make a V stitch into the next stitch. Make a double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 1, and then start with the V stitches. On row 36, there will be no increases. So I'm just going to make a V stitch into each stitch across, into each V stitch across. And then when I get to this point, I'll remove the stitch marker, make a V stitch, and then replace the stitch marker. So at the end of row 36, we'll still have 28 V stitches. So just go ahead and make a V stitch into each V stitch across, and I'll join you when I'm through with row 36. So I'm through with row 36 and row 37. We're going to start as usual, chain 3, turn, make a double crochet into the next stitch, chain 1, and make a V stitch into the next, into the V stitch from the previous row. Just going to keep doing that till we get the max stitch. We're going to be making another increase on this row. We're going to be increasing into the 2 stitches. So at the end of row 37, you have a total of 30 V stitches. So just go ahead and make your V stitches up to this point, and I'll join you when I'm about to make the increases. So I've made it in the marked V stitches. So I'm going to remove this stitch marker, then I'm going to make 2 V stitches into this space. Chain 1, and then that's the first V stitch. Then we'll go ahead and make the second one into the same space. Chain 1, and then double crochet. So I'm going to mark the second V stitch. That's our new center. Then I'll remove this stitch marker and then make 2 V stitches into this space. Okay, 2. Chain 1, and then double crochet. So that's our first V stitch. I'm going to mark the first one. This is our new center. So at the end of of 37. I'm going to be having 30 V stitches. So let me go ahead and make the second V stitch into this same space. Chain one and then a double crochet. So we're just going to the next stitch and then we keep making V stitch into the V stitches from the previous row. If we would like to make this top in other sizes, the recent pattern contains instruction for both size 30 to 62. Yes, it's plus size inclusive. You can find the link to my Ravelry Etsy and Lovecraft store in the description box below. However, you can find the free written pattern of this top on my blog. I'll leave the description to that in the description, the link to that in the description box below. So just go ahead and finish row 37 and I'll join you on row 38. So I'm through with row 37. For row 38, there won't be any increases on this row, so I'm just going to start as usual and then make a V stitch into each stitch across. When you get to the mark stitch, just remove them, make your V stitches and then continue. So at the end of row 38, you still have 30 V stitches. There's no increases on this row. So just go ahead and finish row 38 and I'll join you on row 39. So I'm sure it's row 38. Moving on to row 39 now. Chain 3, turn, double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 1, then start making V stitches. On this row, we're going to be increasing again as we have been doing before. So just go ahead and make V stitches into each V stitch, and when you get to this point, make 2 V stitches and replace this stitch marker into the second one. Make 2 V stitches into this and replace the stitch marker into the first V stitch, and then make a V stitch into each stitch across. At the end of row 39, you have a total of 32 V stitches. So just go ahead and finish row 39. I'll join you at the end of the row. So I'm sure it's row 39. I've made the increases and I have 32 V stitches now. So for row 40, I'm going to chain 3, turn, get this into the next stitch, chain 1, and then start with our V stitches. So on row 40, there won't be any increases. So I'm going to go into each V stitch and then make a V-stitch. So when you get here, just remove the stitch marker, make a V-stitch and replace them back. So at the end of row 40, we still have 32 V-stitches. I'll join you at the end of row 40. So I'm through with row 40 now and moving on to row 41, which is the last row of increases. Chain 3, turn, then make a double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 1 and then make a V stitch into the V stitch from the previous row. So just continue as usual, making a V stitch into each V stitch until we get to the marked stitch, and then we'll make 2 V stitches into this and then 2 V stitches into the next one. So at the end of row 41, we'll have a total of 34 V stitches. So this row 41 will be our last row of increases. So just go ahead and make your 34 V stitches and I'll join you at the end of the row. So I'm through with row 41 and I have 34 V stitches. So moving on to row 42, 1, 2, 3, turn, and then we'll continue the row as normal. Like I said, row 41 is the last row of increases, so there won't be any increase on row 42. So I'll just go ahead and make the row as normal, make a V stitch into each V stitch across, and at the end of row 42, we'll still have 34 V stitches. So I'll join you at the end of row 42. So I'm through with row 42 and I've removed my stitch marker and I have 34 V stitches. So for row 43 to row 45, just going to do the row as normal. Chain 3, turn, you could DC into the next stitch, chain one, and make a V-stitch into each V-stitch across, and then hem the row as usual. So just go ahead and make a V-stitch into each V-stitch, and then the row as usual, and I'll join you at the end of row 45. Made it to row 45. I chained one and then I cut my yarn. I didn't make any more increases, so I say I have 34 V stitches as at row 45. So the next thing to do is to sew up the front and the back panels together. So I counted 6 V stitches from the edges, including the 2 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then I counted the same thing on the back panel, and then I marked those points together on both sides. So that's where I'm going to sew those sides up for the shoulder. And for the sides, I'm going to start from the row 1, and then I'll leave 14 stitches and 14 rows open. So I'm going to sew up to row 31. I'm going to leave 14 rows open for the arm. So I'll just go ahead and sew, and I'll come back to show you what the final piece looks like. So this is what the top looks like. I hope you enjoy watching this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Bye.